Hello, I'm Chen Yi, a third-year undergrad at UCSD, and it is my honor to present a new tree optimization tool, MetaOptimize, that our team at UCSC and UCSD have developed for the massive SARS-CoV-2 phylogeny. The rapid growth of sequences in this pandemic created a challenge for phylogenetic reconstruction. Over 2 million sequences are currently available through the GSeed database alone, with over 1 million sequences added in the last 3 months alone. To keep up with the blistering speed of incoming data, my co-authors earlier developed Usher, an ultra-fast sample placement tool that has been used at UCSC to maintain a daily updated database of SARS-CoV-2 phylogeny. Usher uses mutation annotated tree, in which branches of phylogenetic tree are annotated with mutations that are inferred to have occurred on them. This significantly reduced the memory and runtime requirement for handling closely related sequences comparing to more general purpose tools. However, the sequential placement process used by Usher can lead to suboptimal tree. So we developed MetaOptimize to improve parsimony of the resultant tree. Results on the following two slides are from optimizing a tree with around 360,000 samples using 32 threads. MetaOptimize can achieve a similar or better parsimony improvement with much smaller runtime compared to more general purpose tools. We used the developed version of AccuTree because the release version do not support optimizing for unweighted parsimony. TNT is single-threaded and haven't finished running by the time of recording. Runtime versus parsimony score improvement at different search radius is plotted here. The label around each data point are the search radius. Notice that the runtime axis is in logarithmic scale, and MetaOptimize can achieve most of the parsimony improvement at a small radius. However, parsimony do not improve monotonously with larger radius, because longer distance move is more likely to conflict with other moves. Therefore, if the radius is too large, some optimization opportunity may be missed. MetaOptimize use subtree pruning and regrafting or SPR move. An example of radius 3 SPR move is shown below. All source nodes are searched in parallel for profitable move within the user-specified radius. A move is profitable if it improves parsimony when applied to the fixed starting tree. We use the incremental update method by Glassting to calculate the parsimony score change of a single move. We continue to build onto the mutation annotated tree. In addition, for incremental update of the state of a node and the parsimony score change, we track the major allele set, which are the major allele among all direct descendants of a node, and the boundary allele set, which are the allele whose frequency is one less than the major allele frequency. The state of a node will always be in the major allele set, preferably the same as the parent state. Therefore, the parsimony score contributed by the direct descendant of a node is the number of descendants minus the major allele frequency. A boundary allele can become a major allele if it is incremented, or if all the existing major allele at a node have been decremented. At this stage, as we are only checking the parsimony score change from a single move, understanding how a single decrement or single increment of each allele affect the major allele set and the major allele frequency at each node is sufficient. Next, MetaOptimize will apply profitable moves, but moves can be conflicting if their paths intersect. They may either form loop or can affect each other's parsimony score. Among conflicting moves, We prioritize moves that give the largest parsimony improvement, and then break tie by choosing the move with shortest path. After applying all non-conflicting moves, one round of optimization is complete. Then, MetaOptimize will perform more rounds of optimization, restricting source nodes to those nodes that are within the user specified radius of nodes that have changed in the last iteration. This repeats until MetaOptimize cannot find more profitable moves. The low memory and runtime requirement of MetaOptimize can be attributed to the incremental update method by Glassdin and the specific adaptations to SARS-CoV-2 phylogeny. We use mutation annotated tree, which is a compact representation of closely related sequences, and our native support for polytomy allows us to find more profitable moves within a smaller radius. It also makes parallel evaluation of SPR move viable, because changes to major allele set are less likely to propagate through polytomies. We are excited to have you try our program and the public tree our collaborators have curated. Thank you, and I will be available to answer your questions.